Hey there, what's up, YouTubers? I hope you are having a great day, or a greater day than I am. In fact, I just came back not too long ago from the, from the hospital, and I received some advice from the doctor, but not exactly some advice or any actually professional recommendation in any regard. So I just like to to share a bit of shite that came to my mind. Perhaps you may also find them, marginally or somewhat useful. So here it goes. So this meeting, not exactly meeting, this session I had with the psychiatrist, turned out to be, a little bit less violent than it should, because quite unlike the previous the session before previous session, I smashed a book, a book about philosophy against the floor, and it utterly wrought total desolation and ruin to the book. And but I'm not gonna show you how severely the book got destroyed by my own act of violence after the treatment. Just don't give a sometimes you need to stop giving a piece of shite about people and things. But once you start doing so, it can drive you so crazy and even insane, causing you to lose your sanity and logic and the ability to think with logic and simple and direct reasoning. So it happens all the time, as we can see, throughout the whole world, even around you. Just try to observe, how many people, especially males, have committed crimes of passion, and how many of them, especially in the third world countries like China, got executed. I took myself a bit of time trying to find out, how many people got executed in China and by what method, either by gunshot or shoot to kill, or either by that or by lethal injection. But I'm sure such topic definitely seems a lot more worthy than making one single vid in the future. But I'm just gonna give you my own thoughts and ideas about when to get angry, when not to get so angry, when to get enraged, when not to get so enraged, and when as men we need to give a shite, when we need to give a freaking piece of shite about those shite, or even shitty people, and when should we start giving shite about people. But first of all, you need to give shite about your own health, especially your mental health, not just your physical health. But also, on the other hand, you need to learn how to take good care of people who takes good care of you. And that's one of the most lethal and embarrassing mistake that I ever made in my life, which is I failed to look after my old man when I should, and I have paid a huge price for that, as you can see, a huge price, not prize, but price. Do take note. Learn to differentiate two entities or two people that have so many things in common, yet they also have a few subtle differences. And I suppose that's another crucial skill, or a crucial or indispensable area of skill each and every man has to learn or must learn if he was to become successful, if he was to attain or to maintain good health and good character. good, you know, a productive and useful mindset. Yeah, so I would like to leave the details about my, you know, this consultation session I've had with that, you know, psychiatrist, you know, who has been treating me for nearly 100 days. Actually, not nearly 100 days, but maybe a little bit more than 2 months, as far as I can remember and as far as I know. But I don't kind of, I don't quite remember how many days it has elapsed since I got rescued from a state of homelessness slash exile from a hotel by an aunt and an uncle of mine. Actually, yeah, it was per my request. It you know, I can't say I rescued myself from that state of homelessness or anything, but and yet in also in the meantime, I can't, you know, neither will I say I voluntarily departed from that hotel, from that camping site of some sort, and came back to my grandma on my own accord. In fact, I didn't. Had I been experiencing such tremendous amount of pain and agony and affliction to the point where I could barely think, where I could barely eat my food and feel my belly, you know, where and when I should, I wouldn't have, you know, sent the messages to that aunt, to that, you know, aunt and uncle of mine in the first place, and request their help, you know. Actually, I, you know, quite politely speaking, you know, to, you know, for crying out loud, you know, like I said, you know, I kind of nowadays I tend to quote and unquote what Coach Red Pill has said or has mentioned online on YouTube, and I am beginning to learn the ropes about, you know, I find myself you know, more and more enjoying learning things about red pills, about red pill men, about, you know, MGTOW. So maybe perhaps at the moment I can sound a lot more MGTOW than I used to, even in the previous a couple of days, you know, since I kind of actually, you know, denounced the fact that I could barely consider myself a MGTOW online. You know, I didn't even have the guts to openly admit that I live my life as a MGTOW even online, even without the requirement, you know, of which I have to show my face. I have to reveal my face and some of my political viewpoints, and, you know, for, you know, just for the sake of protecting and preserving my sorry ass. But nowadays I can see an increasingly clearer picture of the whole world, of things that's going on around me. Of course, thanks to God the Almighty himself, and of course, you know, my own effort and a bit of hard work, I might add. You know, it's not about, sometimes it is not about how much hard work you have invested in certain areas of skills or anything, but indeed, it pretty much all depends on your mindset and how you have chosen to view things around you, how you chosen to look at or to examine certain things or certain people or certain people's mindsets and their end games. You know, you have to learn to see through the clouds and veil, the veils. You learn your ropes by trying to unveil their masks, their masquerades, their disguises, and you know, then, you know, only by so doing can you begin to see their true intentions and end games. And sometimes it doesn't even take a lot of hard work neither will it take plenty of your own time. You just need a little bit of more patience, and sometimes you need to, you know, you need to learn, you know, how to differentiate the, you know, two highly similar entities or people or attributes. And you know, but you also need to learn what makes let's just say, for example, what exactly makes a moth you know, differ so much from a butterfly, or what makes a frog differ so much from a toad. You know, that's what I you know, many people, you know, in fact, especially in China, you know, or if, or just in the greater China cultural sphere, I might say, you know, kind of, you know, especially among people of, you know, youths, you know, who have reached their ages of their 20s, their early or late 20s or early 30s, they kind of begin to develop a bit of you know, worshipping subculture about the previous Chinese president, you know. Well, you can Google that online in order to learn more about such subculture. It's called Hath, you know, that I believe, which I believe, you know, was loaned from the King James Bible, which, you know, in which, you know, such yeah, the King James Bible often you know, or I should say always says, you know, hath instead of has, you know. Yeah, you get the metaphor, I as much as I can see. But in any regard, in any event, I hope I have made my points clear in this video. I'm sorry about my grammar, you know, in the background. I hope I haven't, you know, violated her rights of privacy or anything. Yeah, so for the food details, please do not worry. Please give me a bit of a more time to so that I can work on my wordings, on the overall coherence of the language, and a bit of a more you know, you just need to have a bit of more patience in order to get, in order to produce, or to wait for something epic or great to take place. You know, the reason why I'm not saying in order for something to take place, because something are destined, are bound to happen, to take place, because of the universal constant of causality. So do you know, so during your own time, at your own pace, do a bit of a research about causality. Do a bit of a more self studies about various cultures, subcultures, and languages, and a bit of a learn more about you know, philosophy, metaphysics, as well as, you know, some sort of the Bible, of course, because it contains so much, such a broad range, actually, you know, a broad range, if not full range, of knowledge and skills, and, you know, human psychology, even cosmology, you know, for crying out aloud. Yeah. But anyway, guys, I thank you again for watching and listening, and I hope you are having a great day. And please also stay tuned for my incoming Patreon exclusive content, you know, in which I, you know, in which I, you know, I spoke Mandarin Chinese like a M16 machine gun, you know. And I kind of, you know, after I had a kind of not exactly a quarrel, but an argument about human psychology, and also a bit of a world politics with my grandma yesterday night, you know, during dinner time, you know. I also had I also found, you know, myself to have a strikingly different view from my grandma's about men, about you know, men's sufferings and afflictions, and about, you know, how or which side of those parties did more wrong to the other, you know, when it comes to a cousin, you know, whom I love like a sibling, like a brother from another mother, but I still almost always address him as my brother, my elder brother, yeah, in fact, for crying out loud, yeah. But anyway, in any event, please stay tuned for my Patreon, for my incoming Patreon exclusive content. And of course, I shall, as usual, disclose some strands of such Patreon exclusive content publicly on YouTube, so you don't have to worry about not knowing the story. Except you will, of course, you will lose sight of the whole story because I have to withhold certain information in order to make them Patreon exclusive. Right? It's common sense and general knowledge. But anyway, guys, I believe I have talked enough in this filming session, and I hope you are having a great day, an awesome day. If not, then I wish you all the best, and of course I shall pray for you tonight, if God willing. But of course I shall do my best as always to squeeze out some time of mine so that I can make time to pray for you and to pray people like us, including myself. Yeah, anyway, guys. Dinner time draws nigh again, so yeah, just take care of yourselves out there, or if you require any assistance, even if you are currently short on funds, I can spare some to you. You just need to send me a private message via Discord or Patreon, and I shall see what I can do in order to alleviate your agony, your excruciating affliction. So, and yeah, just do not worry about me being a hypocrite. Whenever I say I am gonna help you in any way I can, I truly mean it. So don't worry. So yeah, anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching and listening. Stay faithful, remain steadfast. And stay strong and stay tuned for my incoming Patreon exclusive contents as well as vids that I made publicly available on YouTube. So take care, cheers, and have fun. Bye bye.